The Verifit Skull Simulator allows test box verification of abutment-based bone-anchored hearing devices on the Audioscan Verifit. It's compatible with all Verifit 2 models, as well as Verifit 1, serial numbers 2070 and later. This video will give you a quick demonstration of how to connect and get the Skull Simulator ready for testing. We'll cover the Verifit 2 first, and then the Verifit 1 in the second section. Part 1. Using the Skull Simulator with the Verifit 2. First, disconnect and remove the coupler microphone from the Verifit 2 test box. Remove the Skull Simulator from its packaging and connect it to the coupler jack on the lower right-hand side of the speaker enclosure. For left devices, place the Skull Simulator slightly to the right of the black crossbar in the test chamber floor. The black dots on the Skull Simulator should be lined up with the black posts in the crossbar. The artificial abutment should be perpendicular to the main speaker and the blue label on the Skull Simulator facing you. For right ear devices, position the Skull Simulator similarly, but to the left of the crossbar. Again, the artificial abutment should be perpendicular to the main speaker and the red label on the Skull Simulator facing you. Attach the BAHD, Ponto or Baja style, to the artificial abutment on the Skull Simulator using the typical manufacturer-recommended approach. For left devices, position the left reference microphone 1 to 3 millimeters from the front microphone opening. For right devices, do the same with the right reference microphone. If a programming cable is attached, ensure that it drapes loosely away from the unit and does not push against the test box floor. Tension in the programming cable can cause feedback in the device. Close the test box lid and proceed to your desired test screen. For Speechmap verification, right-click to open the main test menu. Select Speechmap from the test box tests. From the instrument drop-down list, select BAHD. Select the green check to continue. Select Audiometry on the Speechmap screen. Select the desired fitting rule, DSL-BCD Adult, DSL-BCD Child, or None. Select Device to be verified from the drop-down device list. Select from Yes or No for binaural summation correction. Note, this is only available for the adult formula. Select Continue. Enter the dial level thresholds and dial level UCLs if measured by clicking on the graph. Note, dial level values are obtained from abutment-based BAHD-generated audiometry in the manufacturer's fitting software. Select Continue once audiometric information has been entered. Follow your typical verification procedure, selecting the desired test signals from the provided test drop-down menus and adjusting the BAHD as desired to match the provided force level targets. In addition to speech map testing, you can test features like noise reduction or directional in the test box. The tests run as they would do with acoustically coupled instruments, but the display on screen is in force level rather than dBSPL. Likewise, you may run an ANSI test, and again, the test results must be interpreted in force level to compare with manufacturer's data. Part 2. Using the Skull Simulator with the Verifit 1. Disconnect the coupler mic from the coupler jack in the Verifit 1 test box. Disconnect the reference microphone and reconnect it with the supplied black ref mic adapter. Connect the Skull Simulator to the coupler jack. For left devices, position the Skull Simulator in the test chamber so that the artificial abutment is perpendicular to the main speaker on the left. The blue label on the Skull Simulator should be facing you. The black extension will allow the reference microphone to run between the Skull Simulator and the speaker to reach the device. For right devices, position the Skull Simulator similarly, but 180 degrees rotated. Again, the artificial abutment should be perpendicular to the main speaker and the red label on the Skull Simulator facing you. Attach the BAHD, Ponto or Baja style, to the artificial abutment on the Skull Simulator using the typical manufacturer-recommended approach. For both left and right devices, the microphone must be positioned 1 to 3 millimeters from the front microphone opening. Note the routing of the reference mic will be different for left and right devices. The test box lid can be partially lowered, but will need to remain open given the height of the Skull Simulator relative to the test box height. Do not rest the lid on the Skull Simulator. Of course, you must keep the surrounding environment as quiet as possible while testing on the Verifit 1. If a programming cable is attached, ensure that it drapes loosely away from the unit and does not push against the test box floor. Tension in the programming cable can cause feedback in the device. Select Speechmap from the menu. From the instrument drop-down list, select BAHD, select Continue. Select Audiometry on the Speechmap screen. Select the desired fitting rule, DSL-BCD Adult, DSL-BCD Child, or None. Select Device to be verified from the drop-down device list. If you will be entering dial-level UCLs, change this from Average to Enter. Select from Yes or No for binaural summation correction, depending on the fitting. Note this is only available for the adult formula. Select Continue. Enter the dial level thresholds by clicking on the graph. Note dial level values are obtained from abutment-based BAHD-generated audiometry in the manufacturer's fitting software. Select Continue. If you've chosen to enter dial level UCL data, a second similar entry screen will be presented. Follow your typical verification procedure, selecting the desired test signals from the provided test drop-down menus, and adjusting the BHD as desired to match the provided force level targets. Like on the Verifit 2, tests other than Speechmap can be run using the Skull Simulator and DBSPL interpreted as force level. However, positioning limitations in the test box can affect the reliability of directional testing. We hope this video was helpful. More detailed information can be found in the user guide for your equipment. Please visit our website at audioscan.com for these and other resources.